Hey, Dogmeat, you want to play with this teddy bear?
We taught those raiders a lesson. We'll teach them
again.
Yeah,
there you go, boy.
Yep, as someone told me in the comments, it turns out that what triggers Dogmeat to do the playing with the teddy bear animation is not just random, which is what I thought. But instead, if you actually give him a teddy bear, that's what makes him do it. Good to know, because it's adorable. Also, I tried the same thing with a baseball. I tried putting a baseball in his inventory to see if he would play with it, and he doesn't. I also tried dropping the baseball on the ground and tossing it to see if he'd play Go Fetch, but sadly he doesn't.
Look alive.
I wish you played Go Fetch with me, Dogmeat.
Wait there. Come on.
Aww. I hope they add that in a patch or something, or a mod or something like that. I really hope there's just more Dogmeat stuff you can do. I wish you could pet Dogmeat, I wish you could play Go Fetch. Oh, there's so many things I wish you could do with Dogmeat. Anyway, welcome back to Fallout 4. So at the end of the last episode, I was just outside of a Longneck Lakowski's cannery, which I just cleared, and the next thing I was going to do is head to the Nahant Sheriff's Department, which is still what I'm going to do, but before that, I just headed back here to Sanctuary to process my inventory and make sure I have room for whatever I'm going to gather in the Sheriff's Department. And in doing so, you're floating, Dogmeat.
I'll stop complaining when there's nothing left to complain about.
Okay, thank you. Please go back to work.
What's up?
Nothing! Stop! Oh my god. I don't know if I'm cut out to run a settlement. I can't stand the fact that everybody tries to talk at me if I so much as exist in their general direction. Anyway, I was dumping my inventory and I was taking a look at the automatic combat shotgun that I had. And I was thinking about how I want to diversify the weapons that I use. I want to use kind of junkier weapons. Well, not really junky weapons, but I want to use weapons that I'm not ideal with, because I don't have any specific skills that are good for them. And I want to use those weapons and those other types of ammo on weaker enemies, so that I can diversify the kind of ammo that I use. You know, save the good stuff for the hard enemies, and kill rat roaches with something that I don't normally use. And I was going to make that... I was going to make the automatic combat shotgun the thing I do that with. However, I was taking a look at it, and I actually have another shotgun in my inventory, the Tactical Hair Trigger Combat Shotgun. And it turns out, this is way better than the automatic shotgun. The automatic one did like 50 damage per shot, and this one does about 80. Not to mention the fire rate is actually higher than the automatic shotgun. So even though it's automatic, it actually shoots slower. So I'm actually going to make the Tactical Hair Trigger Combat Shotgun, my kind of cheap weapon for killing enemies that aren't very tough.
At least it's not raining.
What I wanted to show you before I left Sanctuary is the modifications that I'm going to do with it. Let's take a look and see if we can soup it up. Alright. Oh my god. So many receivers. So this is a gun nut rank 2, which is good. Means it must be pretty good. That increases the rate of fire. That's nice.
What gives you the idea we're friends?
Nothing. In fact, I don't want to be your friend, Macy. Can you please just leave me alone? Thanks. I'm busy here, doing weapon modifications. So this increases the fire rate a bit at the expense of damage. Powerful receiver does 40 more damage, which is pretty massive, and the fire rate only goes down by 6, which is not huge. Not to mention the accuracy is better. What about this?
Improved rate of fire. Careful. I can fix most things. But people don't fix so easily.
I am going to raise this settlement to the ground, if that's what it takes to make people stop talking to me.
You have the sight.
Improve rate of fire, better damage, inferior range. So how does that compare? It does way less damage. Wow, this thing's terrible. I don't get this thing. Look at the damage. The damage is garbage. Compared to the hair trigger receiver. It does way less damage, the fire rate is less, the range is less, the only thing that's better is the accuracy, and only slightly. And it's way heavier. Yeah, the hardened automatic receiver is just garbage.
You better keep your mouth shut about this place. Can't trust anyone.
It's automatic, but meh. Armor piercing, no thanks. It's gonna be either the hair trigger or the powerful receiver.
I doubt they'll be back.
I mean, I don't mind a better rate of fire. Like, it's gonna use more ammunition, of course, but I'm fine with that, because this is a crap, you know, a relatively crappy weapon that I'm just gonna be wasting ammunition with, basically. So if I'm just spraying and praying with it, and just shooting all over the place and missing a lot of the shots, I don't really mind. But let's go with the powerful receiver.
Speak softly and bring superior firepower, huh?
Thanks, Preston. Apparently Preston approves. Okay, this barrel. Makes it heavier, makes the range way better, accuracy way better. How about this? Superior recoil.
Nothing I hate more than raider scumbags. If you run into any, put a few down for me.
Well, I do want to use this thing up close, so I wouldn't mind leaving it as it is, relatively inaccurate. But, I mean, better accuracy wouldn't really hurt. Better recoil would also be good. Let's try this for now. See how it is. What about the stock? Gun nut rank 2, so that's probably a good one. Better aim with scopes for the marksman stock? Nah, this is a shotgun. Quick eject mag. Better ammo capacity and reload speed. Okay, so this one is simply better than the quick eject mag. Reflex sight. That's good. Definitely want a reflex sight. Circle's fine, I'm sure. Definitely don't want a scope. Yeah, that's okay. Bayonet. I don't care about a melee weapon, so I probably maybe should get rid of that. Oh my god. If you get rid of the muzzle, the range goes way up. Look at that. From 29 to 47. What about the compensator? Improved per shot recoil, improved recoil control, reduced range. But still better than the bayonet in range. Let's just go with no muzzle.
You're tied to this
place. No muzzle's fine.
Your energy.
Alright, this thing is pretty well souped up. Now let's test it out. This thing looks really cool. Alright, let's see. Let's test the accuracies, test how fast it shoots. Whoops. Oh, that's pretty freaking fast. Now, what about the accuracy? Ooh. It's got quite a spread. You're definitely not going to want to use that on anything further away than, like, 25 feet. Yeah, I think I'll stick with that for now. Didn't mean to use that stim pack. Whoops. Let's go back. The cannery. What in the hell is that weapon I'm looking at in the loading screen? Whoa. The hell was that? Also, why won't my weapons come out? There we go. Character was messed up for a second. Where did that happen? It was around the lighthouse, I think. Huh. I think somebody launched a mini nuke or something like that. Okay, so followed a little strip of land to get to the sheriff's department. There is a building right here, one that I've not been to. Oh, people. No, that's not a person. It looks like the outline of a person up there, like patrolling on the rooftop. Nope. Oh, it's a parking garage, huh? Why was there a life preserver in the trash? Would that even fit? Get him, dog meat. Where the hell did it go? Did dog meat bite it to death? Oh, you did. Didn't even see the corpse. Good job, dog meat. Ah, there's another one. Run! Oh, hey. Can I help you? Just a level one iBot. No danger. What the heck is it doing? Just patrolling? Is it a security bot? I thought those things normally just have, like, little bits of propaganda or news on them. Oh yeah, I just shot a rat roach. It does have some defenses. And there's another one. There's a bunch of them. Alright, well, there is, like, nothing of interest here, as far as I can tell. It doesn't say cleared, though, which is weird. But then again, some of the places I've already been to don't say cleared. Maybe it just means you missed an enemy. Yeah, I guess that's it. Alright, to the sheriff's department. You gotta be able to make it across, boy. Ah, forget it. Let's just do this. Come on, dog meat. Come on. He'll find his way over. What was that? Softshell Meyer alert. Where? Oh, legendary. Transformed. Sprint. Let's use something better on this one. No, dog meat. Got it. Got the legendary one. Need to heal. Yeah. Razor claw. Oh god. That one's a lot tougher. I'm sorry, dog meat. I'll get you soon. Jesus Christ, for some reason, sometimes it takes like 5 freaking seconds to switch weapons. I don't think it's like supposed to be like that. I think it's a bug. Dogmeat, I need your help. Help me! Ah! Shit! Oh, fuck me! I was stuck in an animation. Oh. Couldn't move. Okay, let's not use the shotgun there. Yeah, sometimes the weapon switching is messed up. Like, this is how long it's supposed to take to switch weapons, like, 1 second. But sometimes it takes a lot longer. Like right now, I'm switching to my shotgun for like 3 seconds. Oh god! I've got like 1 hit point. Oh! Do I have any nice steaks? Come on, I know I've got some big stuff. Oh, there's a steak. There we go. Shit! Jesus Christ! Oh god, I just awoke another one. Trip, trip, trip! There we go. There we go. That thing has so much health! Oh god! Oh, fuck me! That thing's damage! I had like 75% health and it killed me. Jesus! I'm trying to use my shotgun sometimes, like after I trip them, but then it usually takes like 3 seconds for some reason to switch weapons to the shotgun, and alright, I'm not gonna do any ammo conservation whatsoever. Zero. Oh, my poor ammo. Alright, where's the freaking legendary? Come on. Come on, where's the legendary? Come on, legendary. I know you're out there. Is that you? There you are. Yes, please keep tripping, please keep tripping. Keep tripping! Oh, there we go. Whew. 10% chance to disarm melee attacker on hit. That's a very specific item, one that's not going to be any use to me, but it could be really good if you're facing off against a lot of melee people. What'd you find? Oh. Killclaw? That's got to be a tough one. Be there in a second, dog meat. Oh, you found this, didn't you? Mentats. It kinda looks like somebody's in there because of the boots. Oh shit, there is somebody in there. I thought it was just boots. You know, the classic empty boots. Under the stall door kind of thing. Looks like there's somebody there, but there isn't. Is this breakable? Aha! Thank you. Oh my god. Really? Really? The thing is, the boards aren't actually destructible. When you shoot them, it simply makes them fall from their attach point, and then they just become physics objects in the world. They're not actually broken. So the fact that they're stuck here means I still can't get through, because they won't break in half or anything like that. You know what? Let's try a different tactic. Hey, Dogmeat.
Hey. Head over there.
Let's try this. Take cover! There. That. Whoa! Where the fuck did you come from? Oh, that thing's terrifying! Shoot its claw! That is a terrifying variety of Mire Lurk. Mire Lurks continue to be one of the hardest damn enemies in the game. I remember I had a lot of trouble with him around when I first started, and now I'm having trouble with him all over again. I wonder what level they were, I didn't actually look. Okay, did I blow my way to victory? Kinda. Oh, Jesus. Alright, let's do this again. Come on, dog meat. Oh my fucking god. Fine. Fine, you want me to use the door instead of going through there? That's what you want me to do? No, I refuse. I'm not using the freaking door. These boards are supposed to be destructible and supposed to be able to go through. Come on, let me through. This... fuck... I don't even know what's blocking me anymore. Literally looks like there's nothing even blocking me. Fine. I'll use the door like a commoner. What is up with this doorway? Like, there's nothing in my way, but I just can't go through. Oh my god, I'm going the wrong way. I didn't even realize this little stretch of land. I started realizing that there's a lot of things out here. I'm like, wow, are all these things really on this little place here? No, they're not. We're going for a swim. Why did that car just start spinning? It's like the car just got picked up in a miniature cyclone, spun for a second, and then the cyclone disappeared. Found an enemy. What'd you find? What'd you find, boy? You smell him?
Is that someone who needs me to kick their ass?
Mr. Gutsy? Mm-hmm. Mr. Gutsy.
We have a situation.
Oh! Assaultron! Oh god, that thing's terrifying! Ow! I thought the face laser would probably hurt. So I finally come head to head with the thing I saw on the bridge, the thing that fell off the bridge.
Scanner, weapons hot.
Whoa, 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 shit. Alright, try to shoot off its head. Can I get a crit on its head? Nope. Oh, god.
Minimum distance. Yeah.
It's charging! It's charging its laser! Jesus. Jesus Christ. Jesus. Fuck. Please trip. Oh! Oh! God. Oh. Wow, everything in this area just keeps kicking my ass. Alright, hold on. Let's back up. Let's see what level that thing is. It is level 24. Okay, yeah, I guess it is quite a bit above me. Not that much, though, is it? Ah, fuck. I meant to get away from it before it saw me so I can get a crit on it. See if I can get away from it. Oh, it's shooting dog meat, I think.
I have been programmed to efficiently terminate human combatants.
Well, that didn't work. Huh. I've got really nice crafting components on them. Oh, I think that car's gonna explode, right? It's on fire, I think. No, back up, dog meat. Back up. Yeah, and by the way, you might wonder why I zoom in with the scope when I'm shooting an enemy close up, because it is really confusing when you zoom in. It makes it really disorientating to shoot them. The reason for that is the ability I have that makes enemies fall down when I'm using a scoped rifle seems to only apply when I'm actually using the scope. Yeah, it's gonna blow. It doesn't seem good enough to simply be shooting somebody with a rifle that happens to have a scope. It seems like you actually have to be using the scope for that effect to take place. I'm pretty sure, so that's why I keep zooming in. Almost there. You're an enemy, right? Yeah. It's okay, dog mate, don't worry. We got the bat dog. We're finally here, and this place is tiny. It's so small. I don't even remember why this place was marked on my map. Dog meat, take my junk.
Hey, over here.
Have a couple weapons too, because I've still got like 30 or so pounds that I should be able to get rid of. I think I've still got something weighing me down. Not sure what it is. Let's do ground floor first. Pikmin's calling card. Who's Pikmin? I do remember reading something about Winter a while ago. That must be how this place got marked on my map. Some more cases, usually nothing interesting in here. Just see if it adds anything to my map. Oh, there we go. Yeah, so that's the one I just listened to in Nahant Evidence Lockup, which I just got. The next one is On Loan to Officer Graham. East Boston PD. So that's the location that probably just got marked. East Boston PD. Alright, well, let's keep exploring this little outcropping of land here. So little ammo for this weapon. I use so much up on the Mire Lurks. Doesn't seem to be too much in these old warehouses, but can't shake the feeling that there could be something nice hidden in here. One of these old buildings might have something. Well, I guess not. Yeah, it seems like for the most part it's not worth searching buildings if they're not actually marked on the map. So, I guess in general I won't search them if they're not marked on the map. enemy. What'd you find, boy? What'd you find? Where are they? Take me to them. Mm-hmm. Where? Caution. So they must see me, kind of. Oh, ghouls! Oh, so I just got to level 23. Which means that laserbot thing that I fought before, which I think was level 24, actually was not that much higher than me. Alright, what shall I take? More sneak? I feel like sneaking is just not very effective. It just doesn't seem very effective, but you know, maybe if I keep putting points into sneak, it will be. It's either that, or try to go for Scrapper and Science. Yeah, I can't put another point in a Rifleman, which is kind of my main weapon skill until level 31, so I've got a ways for that. I could make my action points regenerate 50% faster, but... that'd be really nice for sprinting. But beyond that, when it comes to combat, meh. I hardly ever use VATS, it just doesn't seem very effective. Maybe I should take attack dog. Make dog beat more effective. Yeah, let's do it. We're gonna spruce you up and make you fancier, dog meat. What'd you find, boy? What'd you find? Well, you're awfully confused. You need a push. Come on. Come on, boy. You obviously want to go out this way. Oh my god, dog meat. You know, maybe those goggles have gotten fogged up, or maybe they're dirty. Maybe I should clean them. Give you a fresh pair. What are you doing in the floor? This is a master lock. That's the highest level of lock.
That's it.
Oh, whoa. It's an entirely separate instance. Oh god. What's gonna be down here? probably really scary stuff if it's a master lock and an entirely different instance. So before I explore it, let me see what's upstairs. Oh, I see a legendary somewhere. Run! That was the legendary creature. Oh my god! That thing looks brutal. Target is poisoned for 10 seconds. Jesus.
Sweet.
Oh, I just found a key. Dog meat, where did you go?
Yes.
No! Don't push the body down! Let me loot him first. Alright, now we can go down. Oh, his arm's stuck, clipping through the floor. He's not going anywhere. You know, I really do need you, dog mate. There you are, dog me. You're stuck on the stairs.
Hey.
Oh god, don't clip through the wall, dog meat. Let's try the new minigun. All right, I don't think I finished with upstairs. That's what the key's for. Oh, hey! Jesus, this gun is not doing shit! It's doing, like, no damage. See if we can get a crit here. Oh, he's gonna fall down the stairs comically. That was hilarious. Basement key. Oh, well, I've already picked the lock. No need for that. Okay, we still have an enemy hiding somewhere. Yeah, it says they're like right here. Oh, there you are. You know what, Doggy? I want to see. Never mind, it's too fast. I thought this enemy would be weak enough. I was hoping to lower it near Dogmate so I could see Dogmate's new attack that pins him to the ground and increases my chance to hit them in vets, but it's not worth it. Because I was sprinting when that thing hit me, so it's awfully fast. I think I need some Radaway too. Now I need some more food. There we go. Alright, well, I'm sorry to do this, but I think I'm gonna leave this as a cliffhanger. Because apparently this basement is pretty large, and if I keep going, this episode's going to be probably like an hour and a half. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, I'm going to explore the manor's basement.